Oh, right. It's May 3rd, and that first means, actually, congrats to TV Tragedy. They just played the Punk in the Park pre-party in San Francisco, which Punk in the Park pre-party is quite a, like, rolling off the tongue, right? Anyways, congrats to those dudes. Right out of Phoenix here. They came in second in the polling to play Punk in the Park, and they still threw them on the pre-party, so that's fucking awesome. And congrats to those dudes representing Phoenix. But second of all, yes, it actually means May the 4th. Be with you is tomorrow. And yes, this is the best Jedi ever, Ahsoka Tano. We're just gonna put it out there. There's no argument, even though you guys might go for a little Yoda, and that is a little Yoda. And you know, it's a day that people celebrate. It's a little bit of marketing. It's a lot of marketing by Disney Lucasfilm, but you know, you might be throwing out some, you know, classic video games. This actually being a still sealed copy, so we're not opening it, so it won't be played tomorrow. But one that could get played tomorrow and a classic is one of the best video games ever made, and Knights of the Republic. And then, of course, you might have a modern console, and you know, there's this one, which I will admit I have not played this one. I played the first one. I bought it. I have yet to actually sit down and put the time in, so we're gonna throw that out there. But those are some of the best thing. And you know, there's this one, which, man, this game. I thought that was the graphic pinnacle. Then they did Rogue Squadron on GameCube. Yeah. But while we're here, we got to address a Star Wars issue from my childhood. Well, more as a teenager. So I bought a lightsaber back when I was a teenager. Of course, you had to start with Luke Skywalker, which, for cool special effects, green lightsaber. You know, that's not too bad, right? That's not... no, abnormal. And then I had to go and buy a second one. I believe this is the Anakin Skywalker one. I know, despite his acting in episode 3, I still did it. But, you know, the two's not horrible. And then and you can at least do, you know, duels with each other and friends. And then I got further in and, well, we got another one. And this one I bought because... as you can see, it's Darth Vader's, or it's Anakin's. So it's really cool. It doesn't play well, I guess, on bright lights in the green screen, but Darth Vader's cooler, so we're going to just leave that on the red. And that one, the batteries work. The other two, they run on C batteries, but I don't have any handy. And so, but, you know, there was one more. And I'm just going to go. How'd that get there? But there was one more. Yep. I had to get it. If you already recognize the hilt, Mace Windu's. Because first off, I fucking love purple. If you couldn't tell. I think from birth, watching the Suns. But second of all, because I needed one of these cool, fast-action lightsabers. Alright, we had to do some action scenes for the video, right? But even with new batteries, it's not lighting up, so I don't know why. There's no battery acid, but fuck yes. But also, yikes. How do I have so many lightsabers? Who would even allow that? That's insane. I have a problem. Oh well. I like Star Wars, and it permeates everything we do. But, you know, around May the 4th, or maybe on May the 4th, you might be attending a show. And these might be the shows you're looking for. So, let's go. Yes, welcome to another episode of Every Show Joe Says Go, where I recommend shows that I think are awesome, that have at least one artist on them that I think fucking rule, and usually some more on there. And even if they don't, the fun thing of discovery is one of the best things I love about going to concerts and just finding new music and being like, holy shit, this rules. Do they have something to buy, like a CD or vinyl? So yeah. That's the main basis of this. Of course, also still recommending masking, which I know some people are like rolling their eyes, but I've been dealing with long COVID for fucking 22 months as of fucking May the 4th. That day just keeps coming up. So we'll just point out. I also have fucking Well, probably wrapping paper, if that's Star Wars. I don't know how I've done so much Star Wars. Anyways, regardless. Yeah, so I've been dealing with 22 months now, almost 2 years of this fucking bullshit. It's created chronic fatigue and brain fog, and it sucks. So try to do everything you can to lower your risk of this. That's why I advocate for it. And that includes masking. It helps also our touring artists and our immunocompromised friends in those spaces, so the spaces are more inclusive. And our touring friends, which costs a touring, having something that has been postponed or canceled can really disrupt a tour or cancel the rest of the tour because they need the money from each stop. So that's why I advocate for it. So yeah, darling out there. And of course, housekeeping. First off, thank you, Tony Wiley, for the music here at the top every week. He made that. He used to be in the band Dumpster Hump, and it's still just awesome to us, that stuff. And second of all, of course, be sure to like this where you're watching this, whether it's YouTube, youtube.com/everyshowjo, Instagram, Facebook. I don't put it on TikTok. Should I put it on TikTok? I don't know if I could put... I probably could. I don't know how well this is going. Anyways, tangents. But it's also on Threads. It's also on Twitter. It's also on Blue Sky, the real Twitter. I'm trying to think where else... Sit around. Let's just go with that. So be sure to like it wherever you are. And if you are on youtube.com/everyshowjo, hit that subscribe button over there. There we go. You're pointing in the right place. It's free. You get notifications on this content or any other content I post goes live, which when I'm healthy and have the energy and time, it's Twitch stream archives. It's mostly that. But yeah. Anyways. So yeah, do that, get notifications. And also because when those numbers go up, they give you access to more features, including one day maybe making, I don't even know if, I don't think you can live off it, but get some advertisement off of this. And if I keep putting some things that are claimed musically, I probably won't. Well, you can make some. Anyways, that's more tangents. We're just showing a transparency of it. But because of that, I have a Patreon set up, patreon.com/everyshowjo. You can head over there to patreon.com/everyshowjo. And you can head over there and do $1 a month, $5 a month, anything. Consider like tipping me $5, like buying kind of, what is that? It used to be a PBR. Kentucky. There you go. At a bar. Here in Phoenix, or, you know, like buy me a soda or water at some of these venues. Water should always be free, but I know some of those. So yeah, think of it that way. Like giving me a tip, and it helps me out with also when I am able to make gas money, with ticket costs, with, you know, adding to the equipment that I do use here to record, with, so all that kind of awesome stuff. And so, yeah, patreon.com/everyshowjo. There you go. One thing you do for free, though, check out everyshowjo.com. That's where I do post actual writing of the shows I do bring my professional camera to. Like the most recent one was Jer with Devin Kane and Solutions and Susie True and our own Spicy Mayo. And it was fucking blast. It was worth feeling like crap for a week. Like worse. I call them fatigue. This whole thing is done. But regardless, go check it out. Some awesome photos. Some of my best photography. Plus, what a fucking banger of a show at the Trunk Space. So go check that out at everyshowjo.com. Plus, there's a store link in there. You can pick up an Every Show Joe shirt and support me that way too. Many ways to support. Speaking of supporting other things, of course, underneath this, you're like, what is that awesome track playing underneath this week? And you know what? It is this band from Tucson called Annie Jump Cannon that I was seeing on a bunch of flyers. Since I've been seeing them on flyers, I've been dealing with a lot of COVID, so I haven't been able to really catch them either down there or up here in Phoenix. But this is the song Strawberry Fiona, and it's fucking awesome, so I threw it underneath here. Go check them out, especially if there should be a little bit of time by the time this goes up. At least I'm not doing too bad on time this week. You can go check them out and buy it on Bandcamp, because it's Bandcamp Friday till midnight. Support them. It's awesome. And speaking of supporting, things that I like to throw out there every week is fuck racism, fuck homophobia, fuck transphobia, fuck homophobia. All that bullshit that is just hate and, well, basically trying to defy people's human, basic human rights. It's bullshit. Also, fuck genocide. And it's not... that's a whole nother thing. But I... fuck the Palestinian genocide. Innocent people are being killed on both sides. This is some bullshit. And yeah, So things to get involved with is like what I like to throw out there. We got Black Lives Matter, of course. You can always get involved here in Phoenix beyond phxmetro.org. Twitter in Action is another really good one, trying to take down systems with racism built in, tear them down, build something up in their place without that. And that's just fucking cool. We also got 1 in 10 on there helping our young LGBTQIA youth here in Phoenix just grow up and embrace and be comfortable being themselves, which is hard enough even just being a teenager to even go through that in a state like Arizona with the politics and that bullshit. Yeah, so there's some awesome stuff. ACLU's on there. What a soft ape. I hate the Psyduck Project, who's also, I've been noticing some of being out there at the protests in LA. So super cool. And then, of course, Arizona, we did, good news, we did repeal the 1864 absolute abortion law, but we still have a 15-week abortion ban here in this state. So we still are working to make sure that you have a right to choose when you're in the system. And so, of course, I like to, on the website, there is the Abortion Fund of Arizona. But also, be sure to go find those petitions if you haven't and sign them. Let's get it as a state constitutional amendment that women and anyone really with reproductive systems can, it's a choice of them and their medical professionals, their doctors, on what they do and all that. So, yeah. Anyways, speaking of supporting people, of course, this is more music. So let's focus in on the music. And the best, simplest way, of course, every week is to go buy the merch, buy the shirts, the CDs, the vinyls, not the lightsabers. Oh, I could get an Ahsoka. Nope. Ooh, that does sound cool, though. Anyways, we're giving myself ideas. We're not getting Ahsoka lightsabers, as tempting as that is. but yeah. There is ways to go support your favorite artists. Go buy the hoodies or the skateboards that they might do. Or, you know, just get the pins. Or I'm trying to find stuff. I have a bunch of stuff. I even have this Wheelwright matchbook, which that was free. But, you know, go support and grab something and buy them from the artists, from their merch tables, from their websites, from their band camps. And that's the best way, most direct way they make the most out of. So support your favorite artists that way. Of course, Neva, I like to throw out National Independent Venue Association. They're representing your favorite independent venues' interests in our current government. And so they need your help. And they have an emergency fund. That's the other reason why they're cool. They can help out here and there with some of your favorite independent venues across the country. So throw that out there. And then, yeah, the best, the most fun way, the way I miss, I wish I felt, didn't feel like shit most of my week. And even when I do make it out, when it, within three, I made it through Bite Me Bambi, and then I felt like shit within the first few songs, and sat down during Buck the Nine, so sometimes even just two fucking bands. This shit sucks, but it is the most fun when you get out there. That was fucking cool, seeing people talk to people, and singing along to Bite Me Bambi, and to what I could while I was standing up there for Buck the Nine. Anyways, and actually the Two-Turn Lizard Kings, I was singing that bunch. That's probably where I lost. I probably lost my whole energy to the whole thing. Just a blast. Anyways, that's tangents. But reinforce it. Why shows are awesome and attending shows. And I'm going to take a sip of something here real quick. A little water. That's some high quality H2O, right? That's. Anyway, of course, we got shows. We got some awesome stuff. And, of course, we'll start tonight, Friday the 3rd, which all times are Arizona times, which are not the standard time, unless I otherwise say. Or did the math wrong. But these should be all correct. So we'll start at the top, though. The one I'm feeling the worst or the saddest about missing tonight is Escape from the Zoo. We got them playing with the Palmer Squares over Last Signal Live with a Better Problem, Critical Miss. And we'll miss you, Chandler. Fuck, I wish I could make it out and have caught your set, your last set with a Better Problem. But yeah, that's the Last Exit Live, 7 p.m. And we got Galactic Empire, speaking of Star Wars. See, I told you, it just like permeates everything. With Varkin, with Arsenic Kitchen at the Nile, 6:30 p.m. They dress up as Imperials, and they do, as you can guess, rock Star Wars. also, Rockabilly Night, we got featuring Downhill East with the Shake Bombs, Tin Can Screamers, Yucca Taproom, 8 p.m. We got Performance at the Museum with our own Pajama Pyjama, which is just fun to say. And What If We're Robots at the Yucca Taproom, at the Tempe History Museum. There you go. It's down the street from Yucca, though. 7 p.m. You go check that out. Free. And also, really cool, Mama Cole's Dolly Hoot, which is celebrating Dolly Parton. And, of course, they're doing covers by Dolly. With Steph Copen, Brea Burns, Katie May, Tyron Cantrell, Laura Hamlin, Crystal Stark, Angie Del Carmen, Taylor Glasheen, and Grant Bloom over at the Crescent Farm, 8 p.m. We got Strung Out down in Tucson playing with the Casualties and our own Venomous Pinks. We've been on that whole tour, which is fucking cool. Down in Tucson, 8 p.m. at The Rock. We've got also down in Tucson, this one, I've finally been listening to him. Thank you, TA80. And apparently I wasn't paying attention to the Tucson scene when they were big and up and busy. But Troy's Bucket, the return of Troy's Bucket, coming together to play with Sucker for the Sour, Swigfoot, and our own Bocat from up here at the Hut down in Tucson, 7 p.m. And they also got, of course, Scott Kopstein. Speaking of Scott from a decade ago, he was in Real Big Fish for like 2 decades. And he's just awesome. And he plays in the Little Man Band, and he does streams over on his Twitch, twitch.tv/ScottKopstein. 9 p.m. Go tune in, hang out with some awesome people, and hang out with Scott. He'll take requests and chat, and it's one of the most pleasant experiences if you're hanging out at home or watching on your phone through the Twitch app. Then Saturday, we got more, and another, and arguably, some people might call them the best ska band to ever come out of Phoenix, or Arizona. But it is in a kind of memorial for Bob and Candy Fest, they're calling it, as they're remembering their friends, Bob and Candy. But it has Congo Shock reuniting, and friends as they're billed, with Jeff, just as Jeff, with a G. Kilobot and Moonlight Magic. It's at 18638 North 4th Street, Phoenix, E52024. It's a 4 p.m. start, so plan ahead. It is a house. Be courteous. Clean up after yourselves. And but, yeah, we got the return of Congo Shock for a night for celebrating the life of friends of theirs. And then we got more awesome stuff. We got a St. Jude benefit show with Alistair, Paper Foxes, Jaffe's Ascent, and Camtalo and the Humanauts at the Last Exit Live. I apparently put no time here. I think we're going to go with 8 p.m. and I'll update that on the Facebook pin post and on everyshowjoe.com's post of it. And then there's more. Saturday's got the Psychedelic Furs with John Doe of X and Exene at the Celebrity Theater. That one's at 8 p.m. And of course, a May the 4th Be With You show, as they're calling it. And it is comic book day. What a coincidence. That's perfect, like, lining up. But it is, this show is with Breakup Society, Windmills, and an amazing exploding over at Gypsy's Roadhouse, 8 p.m. And then, speaking of free comic book day, whew, it's like I almost knew. we've got free comic book day with Carol and Andy of Carol, Pacey and Honey Shakers, our Wolfistra, I Am Hologram, Exploding Oranges, and Metropolis Man over at Gotham City Comics in Mesa. If you're looking for some awesome music with your free comics, 11 a.m. start for that. We got the Sun Punches with Dearth Roads, Dirt Skirt, and Linger Longer Lounge, 8 p.m. And at the Falkout, we got Tingle Music, Zenora, and Blue Holiday at Falkout, 7 p.m. Plus, looking for a reason to go up to Flagstaff on a Saturday, or you're already up there. There's a cool puncture. We got Winter Haven, we've got Narwhal, and we got It's Fine from down here in Phoenix playing at the Yucca North up there, 8 p.m. And then Friday, fuck. Okay. Brain fog, maybe. I don't know what's going on. It's probably this fatigue. But Sunday, Cinco de Mayo, which is not Mexican Independence Day. But it is a day of celebrating. And so, of course, who better to go see on Cinco de Mayo than the one, the only. You know what I'm getting to? Manic Hispanic. Oh my god. And with Ephraim doing main vocals on it. Oh my god, it's amazing. From Death by Syria. And it's got some amazing support. It has the Limit Club. It has the Belfry Bats. And it's all at Pub Rock Live, 8 p.m. for your Sunday. Holy crap. How are you not going to be there? Unless it's going to this next show. Which is negative 32 out of... is it Sholo? Shit. They're from Northern Arizona. It might be Sholo. But they're here with Louis on tour, with Phil the Band, and then maybe next year's, which that is just a fucking banger of a show, too. Ground Zero Studios, 6:30 p.m. And then, you know, we got Cypress Hill in town, and I know some of you guys might like that show, so we're putting it in the list. They're playing with Souls of Mischief at the Marquee, 7:30 p.m. And I'm throwing it on here. If I was in better health, this would be, I don't think it would be a problem to do the 3.5 hours each way. But Flying Raccoon Suit are playing their first Arizona show in Yuma, in San Luis, so bit of a drive. But I want to throw it on here for anyone that it might be within reach, because they're also playing with the awesomeness that is Epic 18 with Cheers, Steady Souls, at Rolls and Bowls in San Luis, technically, right? I think that's technically. 7 p.m. start, so playing ahead if you are going down there. Down there. From Phoenix. But that's super cool. Hopefully Flying Raccoon Suit will come back through again and play Phoenix. And then we got Bite Me Bambi, of course, speaking of them. They're awesome, and they have their live streams usually at 2 p.m. on Sundays. So twitch.tv/BiteMeBambi, and Talina and them take requests and play, and it's super cool. And then Monday, there we go. Red Leather with New Royals, Barefoot at the Rebel Lounge, 8 p.m. I was listening to New Royals, and that's, I was like, this show sounds cool. So I put them on the list. And then down in Tucson, if you didn't get enough, Psychedelic Furs, John Doe of X fame, and Exene Cervanka at the Rialto Theater, Tucson there, 8 p.m. There you go. And that's a day trip. You can do Tucson and back and still work the next day. I know that from experience. Plus Scott Klopstein streaming usually on Monday evenings, 9 p.m. Tuesday, we got a cool local show with Vintage Clothes, Pleasure Cult, and Cheap Hotels at the Rebel Lounge now at 7:30 p.m. Plus, for hanging out at home or something right after work, depending when you get off. We got Chris Murray doing his Blue Beat live stream. We're on his Facebook, 5 p.m. Plus, Brian Early can tune into Bite Me Bambi doing their stream. That one is a 7 a.m. stream for you. Let's see. Really early. And then Wednesday, we just got Scott's stream taking over 9 a.m. in the morning on Wednesday, so that's super cool. And then Thursday, we got some more stuff. I'm just like catching the brightness I played with. But anyways, Thursday, we got Ballyhoo back, and they're playing with Joint Operation Cloud 9 Vibes at the Nile. That one is a 6 p.m. start, so plan accordingly early. A lot of Nile shows are early. We got Sedan. There's one that I've been following. I've been following them on Instagram, and they seem really cool, so this would be really cool if I could get out to Brenyama. Electrosat is fucking awesome, and Patience at Yucca Taproom. This is an 8 p.m. And then, yeah, there's a lot of awesome on a Thursday here. We got Let Alone with Prince Mirth, Damn the Weather, and it just says more, so there might be more bands. That'd be cool. They're at the Rebel Lounge, 7:30 p.m. But I got more shows for you, too. We got Emily Wolf with the Deadbeat Cousins and Jules at Last Second Alive, 7 p.m. And then down in Tucson, we got Dog Breath, Little Cat, and Sleepyhead at the Groundworks down in Tucson, 7 p.m. Plus Scott Kaufstein's other morning stream, 9 a.m. Then Friday, so far looking a little late, but we got a return of something. We got something I don't know who's playing, so surprise. And we'll get right into it. We got, first off, Adam Ant playing with the English Beat at Celebrity Theater, 8 p.m. And then, of course, this is the one that, I guess, hit up one of the bands for the address. Starbuck and Geo and Uno's birthday bash with just some surprise bands. And they moved up the time, so that means there's more bands playing. 7 p.m. at Daniel Starbucks. Starbuck Daniels? Whatever. His house, 7 p.m. So hit him up. Hit up Geo. Hit up one of them and find the address. One of them plays the Skeleton Army, so if that gives you a direction, there you go. One plays a TV Stretch, and one is the Alex that used to be an Alex Squared that's now a Squared. Anyways, if you're looking for accounts to hit up and message, there you go. And then, of course, we've got Hyperbella, the return of Hyperbella, which is fucking amazing, awesome, super cool. I don't know how many more adjectives I got. Fantastic, ecstatic. Okay, we're stuck. But yeah, it's Harrison Fjord, Stereo Plexima. There's an X there instead of an A. At the Valley Bar, 7 p.m. And then we got Redlick and Holy Heathens, Gold Wax Revival, Doug Preston and the Soul Searchers, and Ghetto Cowgirl at the Yucca Tap, 8 p.m. There is also Tiger Cub with the Props. There is No Us at the Rebel Lounge, 7:30 p.m. Tiger Cub was another one. They're like indie rock, like kind of like the Hives. I was listening, you know. I told you, I like to discover new music. It's fucking exciting, too. Not just telling about favorites, finding some new ones and being like, I think this sounds awesome. You should go check it out. But yeah, they're over at Rebel Lounge, 7:30 p.m. And let's see. Oh, we just got Lawrence Rothman over with Taylor Glasheen, Josue Kinter at the Dirty Drummer, 8 p.m. Plus Scott Kaufstein streaming on his Twitch at 9 p.m. our time. So there you go. There's some awesome stuff. There's some shows that at least one artist or more on them that I fucking recommend. And so go have some fun out there. Enjoy yourself. Be safe about it. Not just in the masking part, but also, you know, get an Uber, a Waymo, a Lyft, whatever. Those Waymos are at least cool from observation. I don't know. I've seen some videos. It looks cool. Anyways. Yeah, so just be safe out there. Have a bunch of fun, though. And spread the word about how you love those fucking artists is the other thing. Because they deserve it. Spread the word. More people hear about it. Maybe go check out their music, their show, you know, like on a Bandcamp. And, yeah, I guess that's it. So take care.